Hi guys, it's Michelle from All Ears English. On this episode, we talk about the word did and how it relates to an experience a listener had with a teacher. So should grammar rules always be followed? Listen in to find out our opinions dealing with the word did. All right, enjoy the episode. And remember guys, hit the subscribe button on YouTube to get all our videos. All right, enjoy, bye.
This is an All Ears English podcast, episode 1152, Why You Must Know the Rules to Break the Rules in English.
Welcome to the All Ears English podcast, downloaded more than 50 million times. We believe in connection, not perfection, with your American hosts, Lindsay McMahon, the English adventurer, and Michelle Kaplan, the New York radio girl, coming to you from Boston and New York City, USA. And to get your transcripts delivered by email every week, go to allearsenglish.com/subscribe. Today, learn how to emphasize, correct, and clarify using the word did in an unconventional way that may not appear to you to be grammatically correct at first, but it works wonders to get the message across.
Hey, Lindsay, how are you?
Oh, I'm doing well. Michelle, you sound very well rested.
Yeah, I did get more sleep than usual last night, but I'm still kind of tired.
Oh, maybe you can catch up on some more sleep tonight.
Yeah, I'll give it a try.
Well, you have a new baby, so, I mean, geez, how's that going? Like, the sleep, how's it going?
Sleep, I mean, so far, you know, he's pretty good. I mean, we've definitely had many, many very tired days. But recently, he's been doing a pretty good job. So let's see.
Good.
But I know that there can be, they can kind of like fall back at some points too.
Yeah.
So, but it's been a good couple of days.
Well, that's good to know. Yeah, I have a few friends who have just had kids, and it's mm-hmm. it's interesting to hear their stories and their experiences.
Yeah, in the beginning it's really, really tough, but
oh,
now that we're several months into it, we're getting there.
Good, that's awesome.
yeah. So Lindsay, I don't know, if did you notice I used did in a way that was like a little bit different?
Did you
hear that?
Yeah,
you right. did.
So
yeah.
How did you use it, by the way?
Well, I mean, I said, yeah, I did get more sleep than usual last night, but I'm still tired. Why didn't I just said, yeah, I got more sleep than usual last night, but I'm still tired?
I guess here you're trying to emphasize, I did get more sleep. You're emphasizing the affirmative in my mind.
Yeah. I mean, I could have said it the other way, but I kind of like this way of using did in this way.
Yeah, for sure. This adds color to our language. It adds like clarity because we're being clear on what our position is on things.
Right. Yeah. So we're going to get into this in a little bit because we have a listener question about it. But Lindsay, you wanted to talk about something else first.
Well, I don't know. Michelle, are you listening to Alexa much these days? Have you been using your Alexa skill?
I mean, I to be honest, I use Alexa mostly for listening to music during the day. I listen to a lot of Disney songs and like kid things.
That's awesome.
My favorite thing to do with Alexa right now. Just like I use a lot of a lot for music. What about you, Lindsay?
So we do the daily news briefing for sure.
Oh yeah.
But I know there are people in Japan listening to All Ears English with the Alexa skill.
That's right.
So you can listen to our podcast, guys, on the Alexa skill. It's really cool because every week we categorize the episodes, business English, phrasal verbs, vocabulary, conversation skills. So you can't really get that on a podcast, right? But you can ask for a category, what kind of episode you want to listen to if you do it in the Alexa skill. Very cool.
Right.
Good idea,
that's
right,
awesome.
Michelle?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. Oh, mm-hmm. my gosh, that's really cool. Like a new way to listen to All Ears English.
Definitely. So guys, go over and if you live in Japan or the US, activate the skill inside your app and then say, Alexa, open All Ears English. And she's probably going to open now. She just did. So go give it a try, guys, and say it in Japanese. Alexa, All Ears English. O iraite is how to say it in Japanese.
Ooh, that sounded good, Lindsay.
I don't know. Our Japanese listeners will be able to tell me how my Japanese sounded there. So we'll see. But yeah, so using did, right? So this is interesting. This is an episode about pronunciation, about emphasis, and about grammar a little bit too, isn't it?
That's right. Oh, yeah. It's a lot about all of those three things.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So Lindsay, so this is a question from, I think, Adnan. Right.
Okay. Yeah.
So
from Vancouver.
Yes. Could you read it for us?
Yeah. So Adnan is saying hello to all three of us. Hi, Lindsay, Michelle, and Jessica. I'm a Three Keys student. So Adnan is in our Three Keys IELTS course. And he said, I started listening to you in September 2018 on the iOS app. I have a question for you, but before telling the question, I'm just going to share a story with you relevant to my question. I was a student at an English course back home in the Kurdistan region in Iraq before moving to Canada. Wow. I still remember when I asked my teacher this question that I'm going to ask you here. He told me it's wrong. Back then, I heard a video on YouTube that said, I did take the course for 3 months. My question is, what does did do here? That's a really funny question. I'm going to say that again. My question is, what does did do here? Is it to emphasize or does it have another function? Please, if you can explain the purpose of using did in past actions, because I've heard it here too that native speakers use it. By the way, I rated the iOS app a 5 stars because you deserve it. Love you guys.
Aw, thank you.
Thanks, Adnan. That's fantastic. Thank you so much.
Yeah, such a good question. I've thought about this one a lot, actually. Whenever it kind of comes up naturally, I sometimes think about how it's like kind of unique and it's fun.
Yeah, this is a good question. This is a great question.
Yeah. Well, why do you think so? Adnan said his teacher rejected did when he used it. Why do you think?
Well, I can see why. It's because I think probably his teacher was thinking about it out of context. Yeah. Just the phrase by itself would be weird, right? Because you need to know the whole context of what you're trying to say. You need to hear the emphasis in the voice. So there's a lot of ways to actually do this incorrectly.
right. That's true. That is true. Yeah, I think, you know, probably the teacher was just focusing on the, you know, basic way to use the past tense. Maybe he didn't want to, you know, to kind of throw too many things into the mix to change it up. But there are reasons to do it, and it can really kind of make your English a little bit more colorful.
Yeah, and I think this is where we have to kind of discern our level, right? Because I would never teach this to a beginner English learner, right? The beginner English learners need to learn, okay, what are the building blocks of grammar? But once you guys get to this level, if you can understand 80% of this show, then you're ready for this usage of did, which is a bit more advanced. So
right. Yeah, so let's get into it. So I was thinking about when do we use this and with emphasizing, and I came up with two different ways. So one is just basic to emphasize, right? So this example from YouTube that you talked about is that I did take the course for 3 months. So I didn't hear the whole thing. So it's hard to know because I, like Lindsay said, we don't have the context, but it must have been some sort of emphasis. Like, oh, I did take the course for 3 months, you know, maybe saying just like, you know, that it's maybe it's impressive that you took the course for 3 months or something like that.
Right. Like I could say, oh, wow, you passed the test. Great job. And then you might say, what, Michelle?
Well, I did take the course for 3 months.
3 months. Perfect. Yeah. So that's the point of context, right? Out of context, it doesn't make as much sense. It doesn't feel correct. But in context, it's perfect. Guys, I'm using my Amazon Echo more and more at home. Have you tried our Alexa skill yet? If you're in the US or Japan, just activate the skill and then say, Alexa, open All Ears English or All Ears English wo iraite in Japanese. You can listen by category, or the skill will even remember the last episode you heard and give you the option to continue right there. Go and check out the Alexa skill. Thanks, guys.
Exactly. Yeah. So let's just do some other examples. So one, let's say, okay, I did order the cake, or I ordered the cake. So both of them are correct. One is this way with did and just like the regular verb order, right? And one is basic past tense. Okay. Mm-hmm. So let's try it out, Lindsay.
Yeah. So why didn't you order the cake, Michelle?
I did order the cake. It just didn't come on time.
Yeah. See, there you go. I mean, you need to use did in that emphatic way there.
Right. It's important. And did I just say to you, oh, I did order the cake. It just didn't come on time.
No.
No. What do I do with did?
You said I did order the cake. Right. Yeah. It just didn't come on time. And it's so important to communicate. And obviously, like in some cases, that could become a tense situation.
Right.
but you do need that skill to say, actually, I did do it. I did order the cake. Right. Yeah.
Right.
This is huge.
Right. 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 So the bigger the did, the more like, so if I say I did order the cake, you know, it can sound like I'm getting argumentative. Yeah. But if I just say something like, yeah, I did order the cake, you know, it may be like I'm just, you know, kind of emphasizing that I didn't make a mistake. I did do what I said I was going to do.
Yeah, I think this is such an important connection skill, and it's a key like skill for our listeners at their level, intermediate to advanced. You guys want to add this to your repertoire for sure.
For sure. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, what about another one? So let's do two. So one would be, I did call you last night, and one is, I called you last night.
Okay. All right,
so here we go. I thought you were going to call me last night, Lindsay. Is everything okay?
I did call you last night, but it went straight to voicemail. You didn't get a missed call?
No, how weird.
Okay. Another good example, right?
Yeah.
So it's kind of when you're negating or you're disagreeing with what the person said, it's important to put the did there.
Right, right, right. And here's another one. So Lindsay, this is with I did learn a lot or I learned a lot.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I did learn a lot in class, but I just wish the teacher gave more individual attention to students. So, yeah, so here it's not between me and another person.
Exactly.
It's between the beginning of my phrase and the end of my phrase, the two sections of my phrase, right? So what do you think, Michelle? Yeah.
Yeah, I think that that's a really good way to emphasize. Yeah. So I think that that's a really good one. And then the second way, which incorporates a little bit of the first way, is to clarify or correct someone's mistake. Right.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So here's another one that I thought of. So here we go. So you didn't go to school with Tracy, right?
No, I did go to school with her.
Oh, I forgot.
Yeah. So, and this gets into other episodes that we have done or could do in the future when we agree and disagree whether we put yes or no at the beginning, because I know it's different in
right.
other languages, guys.
Yeah.
But don't worry too much about that part of it. Today, let's focus on the did and what is the function of that word here. Yeah.
Right. Exactly. Okay. So here's another one.
Okay. You didn't give me your phone number last week, did you?
I did give you my phone number. See, it's right there.
All right, thanks.
Okay.
Forgetful. I'm so forgetful.
Right. So this one is kind of similar to some of the ones above about I did get the cake, I blah, blah, blah. You know, it's kind of correcting or clarifying, but it's a little bit more just like correcting what someone thought, right?
Yeah. So that's a good, so I like how you said that. Correcting and clarifying. That's what did does.
That's what did does. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Or just emphasizing in general. So I think, you know, the main thing is to remember that this is about emphasizing, right? It could be correct to correct. It could be to clarify.
Yeah.
It could also be to show surprise or for some other reason why something is important, right? Like like we talked about before, I did learn a lot in the class, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this is important. Like this was positive. However, blah, 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 right?
Yeah, yeah. Cool. I like it. I like it. This is going to be one of the top most useful episodes.
Yeah, I think this is a really naturally used way to practice using did. And I think you'll start to realize that you hear it a lot more once you kind of perk your ears up to it.
Definitely, especially around natives. That's why we need to be practicing in native circles with native speakers so that you do hear this usage and you
For
start
sure.
to say, oh, I want to try that. I want to use that. That will push you to that next level.
That's right. That's right. So I wanted to put it together in one larger role play. So Lindsay, let's try it out. So in this one, I'm keep on trying to think of new contexts because I know we do similar ones. So in this one, okay, we work together, but we're also best friends.
Nice.
So we work at an ice cream shop.
Oh, that's so fun. It reminds me when I was in high school, my best friend in high school worked at a candy shop and we used to go in there all the time. I would go when she was working and just eat candy.
Oh, that sounds like a
all
good friend.
All the time.
Okay.
All right, here we go. All right. Did you try the new chocolate chip flavor we just got in?
I did try it. Oh my gosh. It's so delicious. We also have a new orange sorbet, right?
Ugh. I don't think I heard the boss say that.
He did say that yesterday in a meeting.
Oh, right. You heard that cones are on special today for 50% off, right?
I did hear that they were discounted, but I didn't know for how much. Oh, no, Lindsay, you forgot to RSVP for Rachel's wedding. She just texted me.
What? I did RSVP. I'll text her now. Ugh.
Okay. That was a lot of uses of did like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, was right? A lot.
It was a little much, but guys, it shows you how it could be used.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Probably wouldn't be used so much in that one little conversation, but
exactly.
Yeah.
But you never know. You never know.
You never
but
know.
It's a good way to put it all together, right? So the first one, so you asked if I tried the new flavor and I said I did try that. So that's more just to emphasize it, right?
Yeah, for sure. I could see this being used a lot about food. Hey, have you tried this new? Did you try the cake I brought? I did try it. And you're smiling and you're nodding.
It's so good. Yes.
All right. What else? What else? Let's see. So then I said, I don't think I heard the boss say that. He did say it. Then you said he did say that yesterday in a meeting.
Yeah. So I'm kind of like correcting you in a way, also emphasizing.
Yep. Okay. And then
you asked me if I heard about the new special. And I said, I did hear that they were discounted, but I didn't know for how much.
Mm, and that's another good use of this when you want to say something positive, like I did hear, but then you want to say something negative, but I didn't know. So you're showing the difference between the two. You did hear that they were discounted, but you didn't know for how much.
Right.
Really good. Really good. Yeah.
Right, right, right. Exactly. Exactly. Okay. And then what's next? Oh,
that's it.
That was it.
That
no,
was
no, no, no. Wait, wait, wait. No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't. There was about the RSVP. I told you. You forgot to RSVP. And you said, what? I did RSVP.
Oh, yeah. What? I did RSVP. So here I'm emphasizing because probably the technology isn't working right. You know, maybe I RSVP'd on a website and it didn't go through. So I'm frustrated.
Right,
at least that was
right,
my
right.
impression of what I was saying.
Right.
So I did RSVP. Oh, I'll text her now.
Right, exactly. Yeah, so guys, you can see correcting, clarifying, emphasizing. These are all ways you can use it.
Yeah, this is great. I love this episode, actually. It's one of my favorites because I think it's going to be super useful for our listeners, Michelle.
I like it, too. I like the question a lot. Yeah.
Yeah.
So thank you for that. So what's the takeaway for today, Lindsay?
Well, guys, I mean, you need to know your level when it comes to adding new grammar tricks to your repertoire. Grammar can change depending on kind of the emotion that you're trying to express. And in this particular case, this is really important to be able to do this.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And so what else, Michelle? Anything else with the takeaway here?
Yeah, I mean, it can depend on, you know, emotion also. Like, so I think sometimes, you know, when people hear grammar, they're like, ugh, you know, like it may not seem that exciting. But, you know, there are parts to learning the grammar that can not just be about right or wrong grammar. It can be about choosing to say something in a certain way for a reason.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah, I think, and just to that end, Michelle, I think it's, or for our listeners, guys, I think it's like you have to know the rules to break the rules. You know what I mean? Like,
yes,
if you look at the rules of grammar, this kind of breaks the rule in one sense, but it's okay because you know that it does and you know what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? You know that there's a function, there's a reason why you're putting did there and you're getting something done with it. You're conveying a message.
Right, right, right. I think that's really important. And yeah, that know the rules to break the rules thing. Oh, that's, I think that's really important. In English, I mean, you think about it in music too. I mean, it's similar. But I think, you know, we can get into that more in another day about this concept of knowing the rules to break the rules.
Yeah, that's true. Like musicians, the great musicians obviously don't follow all the rules and that's how they created their great works, but only after they knew how it really works, what those rules were. Okay. I think we made our point here, Michelle. This is good. This is good. Thanks for hanging out today.
Fun. Thank you, Lindsay. And thanks to everyone for listening. And thanks to our listener for that question.
All right. Talk to you soon. Bye.
All right, bye.
Thanks so much for listening to All Ears English. And if you need a 7 or higher on your IELTS exam to achieve your life vision, then our insider method can get you there. Start with our free video series masterclass. Get video 1 now at allearsenglish.com/INSIDER. And if you believe in connection, not perfection, then subscribe to our show on your phone or on your computer. See you next time.